That about wraps up the things that you have to do to be able to complete the required submission. So if we bounce back to the main page, we have gone through all the items that you need to be able to do in order to properly complete the items that require submissions. And so when you're done, I would like you in the first week of the semester to complete these four activities. It should not take you more than an hour or so. And so the first activity is an initial response activity. And basically what I would like you to do is I would like you to hit submit, and I would like you to either tell me, I feel comfortable navigating the class, I understand that, you know, we'll always do our work via the home tab, and just in general, I feel comfortable and I don't have any questions. Or you need to say, I have questions and these are what the questions are, and you can ask 100 questions if you need to, but you should submit them here so that I can respond to them as soon as possible. Your instructor will check this multiple times per day, every day of the semester for the first 2 weeks of the semester, so that we're answering your questions as soon as possible. The second activity is a profile picture. I would really like you to have a profile picture. It allows me to feel like I'm getting to know you a little bit better. And I would like you to click on your account tab up here and enter profile picture. With that being said, if you get an error that says that your file is too large, double check it, because most times your file is not too large. What it's telling you is that your storage on Canvas is too high, and if that's the case, you have to go into your old courses and delete some of the files. You can find them under the account tab. I would like your picture to be close up of your face so I can actually see you. If it's you standing on the edge of the Grand Canyon from 50 feet away and I can only see that it's a person, that doesn't help me know who you are. I do not want a solid color or a cartoon. I would like a close-up of you and only you. So don't put a picture of two faces side by side. I want your picture close up. It's only 5 points if you don't do it. It's not going to make or break your grade, but you won't get credit for that unless it is a clear picture close up and you can actually see who the person is. The activity that will probably take the longest during the first week of the semester is the introduce yourself to the class activity. We're going to use a discussion board throughout the semester, and so I want you to practice using it this week so that when it's time to actually submit something that's kind of worth a lot of points for your grade, you're not panicked that it's not going to work. And so it's a fun activity. Just talk about yourself in a minimum of 3 and a maximum of 5 paragraphs. My biggest pet peeve in teaching online classes is when students don't write in full sentences and use proper grammar. It's college. I shouldn't have to state that. I shouldn't have to say that a full paragraph is not one sentence. It should be, you know, 5 to 7 sentences, and it should be descriptive, and it should be easy to talk about yourself for 3 paragraphs. You can read my little paragraphs. I included a picture. I should probably update this picture. This picture is a couple years old at this point. But I like to travel, so I posted some pictures of places that I've traveled to. And I have like 85 cats, so I posted pictures of my cats. I don't actually have 85 cats, but sometimes it feels that way. And then most importantly, I put at the bottom that I love what I do, and that is 100% true. I never feel like I ever have to go to work. I never feel like, oh man, I got to go onto campus and I have to work today. I love what I teach. I love helping students. I love creating projects and making these videos. And so if you have any questions at any time, please don't hesitate to ask. I get a lot of emails that say, I know this is a stupid question, or I know you probably answered this in the video. I just am still stuck on it and I'm really sorry. You don't ever have to be sorry. I would rather answer your question 40 times than to have you not ask it and never get an answer. With that being said, I would like you to email me via the Canvas inbox or directly to jcurran5@bruinmail.slcc.edu if I'm your teacher. If I'm not your teacher, email your own teacher. And then if I don't reply back within 24 hours, Monday through Friday, just flip it again. Just basically forward it back to me. Sometimes I click on emails and I read them, and then I close out of them or I get distracted, and then I forget that I read them. So if you don't hear back from me within 24 hours, just send it again, because I strive to reply back to all emails within 24 hours. But that's Monday through Friday. I try not to reply back on the weekends. So if you email me at 4 o'clock on Friday, you may not get a response until 4 o'clock on Monday, because that would be 24 hours from the time that you sent it.